White and the Huntsman, short review. Snow White is the princess, and when her, soon after her mother dies, the evil, I think it's like Ravenna or something, but I'm gonna go with Raven because it's easier to remember and it's very obviously evoking that sound, name, something. Raven comes in and seduces and marries the king, then kills him, and now she has her own kingdom. For some reason, she didn't kill Snow White, and Snow White soon escapes, a few years later, escapes when Raven wants her heart, so that she will never have to soul-suck youth out of random prisoners anymore. And Snow White hopes that with, I think, Duke Hammond is his name, and his small army, they can, you know, reclaim her throne. And yeah, that about covers the plot. This is a great summer blockbuster. I really wasn't expecting it to be anywhere near this good, but yeah, Kristen Stewart doesn't resemble Bella in this movie at all. There is no twilight over this. There's not even a love interest. Yeah, there are two male protagonists, but only one of them wants to do Kristen. The other one makes it perfectly clear that he has no such interest, no interest in such actions. And yeah, she's a very engaging, likable character, actually. And so is Chris Hemsworth as this self-destructive, drunk widower who's basically, yeah, he wants to die because he misses his wife, and yeah. And he has this nice kind of bitter edge to him, which never crosses into emo, which is, you know, quite vital to something like that. The action is well choreographed, epic, and a lot of fun. There are some really great battles. And in general, the movie is very epic, with grand sweeping landscapes. The dark forest is just scary, like you wouldn't believe. Snakes and carcasses and just really nasty and terrifying. The movie does slightly overuse slow-mo, which there is not terribly much of, but you know, basically half the time it uses slow-mo, it doesn't work out quite all that well. The characters in general are quite good, and the acting, definitely. They picked some really great people for the Seven Dwarves, and this, I guess partially because the technology is finally here, actually uses regular people, actors, and not, I don't know, little people, to play the, or at least, you know, maybe they just replaced the heads, I'm not entirely sure, but yeah, they look like little people, but it's, you know, there are a couple of telltale, you know, very familiar faces in there. Charlize Theron is terrifying as the queen, especially when she shouts. It's very commanding. And she actually has a proper character. You know, basically she hates men. She worries that they will betray women, you know, once their beauty fades. So, yeah, you know, her actions make a lot of sense. And she is very much acting out of, basically, you know, self-preservation, that instinct. This follows the basic fairy tale pretty well, altering some elements, and yeah, it's a lot of fun, definitely worth watching, and worth watching in the theater if you're up for, you know, basically, you know, good fun entertainment. It's not, it follows the cliches, and it follows a lot of the Hollywood, you know, that kind of structure, but it's still a really good movie within that, you know, kind of, that genre. If you like this review and want a more detailed one, check below. It's there as a video response. If not, it'll be in the description box. Please rate and comment, and hey, if you like this video, that subscribe button's just waiting for you to click it.